Hi, this is Mato. Welcome to my online chess lecture. In this video, I will show you a game between Akiba Rubinstein and Rudolf Spielmann. This game was played in Germany in 1921. Rubinstein had white pieces and he started with d4. Spielmann played knight to f6, knight to f3, c5, going for the Benoni defense, d5, d6, and now not c4, but knight to c3. Black to move. Bishop to f5 was played. The standard move is g6, and then white most of the time plays e4. Back to our game. Bishop to f5, preventing e4, maybe. Knight to d2, insisting on e4. e6, e4. Bishop to g6, white to move. Bishop to e2 was played. Bishop to b5 check was preferred by modern players. And after knight from b to d7, white plays d takes on e6. After f takes on e6, knight to c4. And white stands slightly better, even when black takes the pawn on e4. But this is a game for another time. Back to our game. Bishop to e2, a6, intending b5. Maybe a4, e takes on d5, e takes on d5, bishop to e7, and Rubinstein castled kingside. Black to move. Castling kingside was expected, but Spielmann decided to play sharply. He played h5, knight to c4, knight from b to d7, rook to e1, aligning the rook with the black king, king to f8. Bishop to f4, knight to b6, black has less space and wants to exchange pieces. Knight to e3, h4, a5, more space on the board on the queen side. Knight to c8, h3, knight to h5, bishop to h2, bishop to g5, bishop to d3, threatening bishop takes bishop on g6. Bishop takes on d3, queen takes on d3, rook to h6, the rook lift, rook to a4, knight to e7, knight to g4 attacking the rook, rook to g6, f4, white pieces are better placed, bishop to f6, f5 attacking the rook, bishop takes on c3, b takes on c3, rook to g5, threatening to take the pawn on f5. Knight to e3, g6, f takes on g6, knight takes on g6, rook to g4, offering to trade the rooks. And that is the best black rook. Knight to g3, bishop takes on g3, h takes on g3. It is white to move. And this is very interesting moment of the game. Rubinstein played knight to f5. Let's take it back. Rook to f1 was recommended by annotators after the game as the best move. And if now black plays knight to e5, forking two pieces, then queen to h7, and white stands much better. Back to our game. Instead of rook to f1, like I said, move which was recommended by annotators after the game, Rubinstein played knight to f5, and spectators were not sure if it was a blunder or a trap of some kind, because Spielmann played knight to e5, forking the queen and the rook. Which piece to save? Or maybe white should play rook takes knight on e5. What would you do? Rubinstein played queen takes on g3, knight takes rook on g4, h takes on g4, queen to f6, knight takes on d6, rook takes on d5. Indeed, black is better materially, but rook on a8 is still sleeping. Can white do something quickly before the sleeping giant comes into the game? What would you do in this position if you had white pieces? Rubinstein played knight takes on f7. Did you see this move? King to g8, let's take it back. If queen takes on f7, then rook to f1 isn't pleasant. And of course, if king takes on f7, again, rook to f1 is extremely unpleasant. Back to our game. King to g8 was played. Rook to f1, attacking the queen and defending the knight. Queen to g7, g5, and now Spielmann brought the sleeping giant into the game. Spectators were now sure that black is winning. Is black winning? It is white to move. What would you do? Please pause and find the best move for white. White, play the move, and black resigned. Is it magic? What is the move? It is g6. Spielmann resigned. And spectators were not sure why. They thought that Spielmann was winning after rook to f8 was played. Why did Spielmann resign? In some variations, white is intending rook to f4 and then rook to h4, rook to h8. So let's examine two lines here. First, if rook goes to d7, then one line goes like this. Queen to g4. If rook takes the knight, then queen to e6. Funnily, black has no good moves available, believe it or not. After, let's say, c4, then rook to f5. If the queen moves to h6, then rook takes on f7. After rook takes on f7, g takes on f7 check, king to g7, queen takes queen check, king takes queen, and then pawn to f8, queen, white wins. And let's go back. How about rook to h5? Then one line goes like this. Queen to g4, rook to d5, queen to e6. If rook goes back to h5, then g4. The rook, say, goes to h4. How would you continue in this position then? Then knight to h6 check. And after, this is double check. And after king to h8, rook takes rook check. Queen takes rook. Queen to e5 check. Queen to g7. Queen to b8 check. Queen to f8. And then queen takes queen check mate. Amazing, isn't it? And let's go back to move 36. So, black was not winning. It was just an optical illusion. Black had two rooks against the rook and the knight, but the white knight was not an ordinary knight. It was a dragon. What do you think of this game? And that is all. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. I wish you good luck with your chess, and bye for now.